What is going on, guys? That is an annoying rattling sound. What's going on, guys? Matt, E3 Athletics. You can't see it because I'm wearing a sunbelt. A sunbelt? Oh my god. Oh boy. Slow down, Matt. I'm wearing a seatbelt, not a sunbelt. So, we're heading home. I have one Skype client check-in to do here, and then I'm going to take you guys through what I am doing to get ready. Ready for it. So I talked about this in a previous video. I was on the fence as to whether or not I wanted to compete in October, but I do. I am going to. So I've officially started prep. I got all of the junk food addiction out of my system last weekend. So today's Tuesday, June 7th. So Tuesday, June 7th. Today we have measurements. I need to find out where my body fat is. It's probably still somewhere around the 12% range, because while I have been doing cardio, I haven't been eating correctly. So, and I can't expect that to have dropped any in 2 days. Oh my god, rattling. I've got some stuff in my car right now. It's rattling everywhere. So, we're going to do measurements, and then I'm going to take you guys through what all I'm doing for my prep. I had initially thought that I was going to hire a coach because I have truthfully never competed before. I have been really, really lean and in good shape before, but I have never gone to the point of competition. So what I decided, however, is, and don't take this as me being negative, because I'm not. I'm not trying to be negative here, but what I'm being realistic. I am not going to place. And I know this going into it. This is not about winning. This is not about losing. What this is about is pushing myself to do something that I've never done before, because I have never competed. And I kind of wondered, and I've always wondered what the point of going into the gym day in and day out and training the way that I do, what the point of that would be if I'm not going to compete. And I haven't competed thus far because I was worried about my health. I've been worried about injuries, which are very common with me already. So pushing myself to the point where I'm training 2-3 times a day had me worried. And then I have some complaints about the sport of competition, and I don't think it embodies necessarily being healthy, which is something that I am very adamant about, very passionate about, is actually being healthy. But at the same time, I feel like I need something to give myself that push, and I think competition, I guess I've never tried it before, so the worst thing that could possibly happen is I try it and I absolutely hate it, and I don't do it again, but at least I'll have that experience under my belt. And so it's just something that I feel like it's time for me to try. And as I was talking about just a second ago, about I had thought about hiring a coach. Realistically, I'm not going to place. My physique is not in a position where I'm going to place. And that's okay. I'm fine with that. This is about the experience, going through it, and pushing myself to do something that I've never done before. It's not necessarily about walking away, winning the competition, because in my head, just getting to the competition, doing it, completing it as my first one will be worth it enough, is the goal. So instead of hiring a coach, I'm not going to, and I'm going to do my prep by myself. Now, if it's something that I decide that I like doing, and it's something that I want to continue doing, then probably I will become more serious about it and hire a coach for my next prep. But I'm definitely not going to be competing again this year, because we've got the baby on the way. So I picked a date. October 1st is going to be the competition date, and it's going to be before the baby is due, just barely, about a month before. So we're not taking anything away from that. And then maybe next year around this time I'll compete again. But we'll see. It's just, like I said, it's just something I want to do. And it's something that I feel like I need to push myself towards a goal. So in life, if you don't have goals, I don't think you can necessarily find out what you're capable of. And especially if you don't fail at those goals. If you never fail at something, there's a video. Denzel Washington gave a really amazing graduation speech at a college years and years ago. And one of the things that he said that really struck and has stayed with me is if you don't fail, you're not even trying. And he says, I'll say it again, if you don't fail, you're not even trying, because nobody is ever perfect at something the first time. Nobody, you know, success isn't something that happens overnight. We talk about these stars and these people that have overnight success. And then you find out that, no, they've really been working towards this for a long time. It's just they finally had that big break. But overnight success isn't a real thing. It's not something that you just get. Even these stars who seem to be an overnight success, you know, these movie stars, they did extra roles on TV shows where they weren't even credited for years and years and years before they even got their big break, right? So overnight stardom, overnight success is not a thing. So if you're not, you know, if you've never failed at something, then you're not even trying to do it, because honestly, you should never be perfect and succeed amazingly well the first time you ever do something. It's a process of getting better and bettering yourself each and every time you do something. So one of the big things that I live by is the saying of progress every day. So I don't compare myself necessarily to other people. I try not to compare my physique to other people. What I try to compare it to is myself the day before. So long as I'm progressing and doing a little bit more, or not necessarily more, but better than I did the day before, and so long as I'm putting in effort, that's success to me. So progress every day. So we've got a meeting here right now. It's about 12 o'clock. Once I'm done with that meeting, I'm gonna grab a meal, and then we're gonna go through and I'm gonna show you guys everything that I'm doing to get ready. So let's get at it. So as I walk in, this little demon has caused this mess. Look at this. Look what you did. Come here. Sit. What did you do? Tell me what you did. Tell me what you did. What did you do? Were you a bad puppy? Tell me about it. She knows. You know you were bad, huh? Yeah, so it doesn't matter how often I actually hide things from her. She finds a way to get into things. So she knows she did something bad, don't you? Come here. Tell your daddy you're sorry. Tell your daddy you're sorry. She's a good dog. All right, so let's go over a couple things. Now that, look at my face. Look how red that is. Sunburn. That sun's coming out, so it's actually nice and warm here in Washington now, and it's not rainy. So, got that sunburn going on. So let's go over a few things. So prep-wise, I have roughly 18 weeks to get ready. So what we're doing is, let me put this down for just a second. Ironman competition waffle. Coming events, DC news. So the show that I'm doing, I'm just pulling it up for you guys here. The show that I'm doing, Washington Ironman, craigproductions.com, is an NPC event. So that's, amateur, obviously. And Iron Man, here we go. Venue. So, these are the natural championships October 1st. Judging is at 10 a.m., finals are at 6 p.m. Okay? So, it is a drug tested NPC national qualifier. Not that I'm going to place nationally, I'm not going to place at all. I know that going in, and that's fine. So it's going to be at the Gold Creek Community Church. That'll be interesting. I really like the promoters of this event. They're very family-oriented, and they are very nice, I guess, to say. So let's talk about my training plan. So I'm going to go into my thing. I'm going to use what I always use for, I use the same app that I use, that I set up my clients' plans on. So it's really nice, makes it very easy. I'm sorry guys, my brain's not working, I'm carb depleted. I've been low the last couple days. What I'm trying to do, so let's just talk about this real quick. So for the first couple weeks, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stabilize my diet, because my diet has been all over the place. High, low, too much, too little, too, you know. And so what I have to do for the first couple weeks is get my body used to eating the same thing consistently, because it's not going to want to let go of the fat if I'm all over the place. And so I'm trying to figure what that looks like for me. And one of the things like I said earlier, that I'm trying to do is not sacrifice family time and that. So if that means that I have to sacrifice a little bit about how I do on the show in order to not take away too much time from my family, that's something that's important to me, and that's okay. So I'll be going into this diet with a more of an idea of if it fits your macros style of dieting, so flexible dieting with numbers in mind to hit. Once we get to about a month out, maybe 6 weeks, I'm going to go to a more strict regimen of food just to make sure that I can control every aspect as we get down into the lower portions of my of the contest prep. So the last few days I can feel that I have not gotten enough carbs because my brain's just not fucking working right. So anyway, so the training plan, training isn't going to be much different than what I've been doing recently. It's just going to be more consistent. And so I'm doing three things each day. My workout, my main workout, so today was legs and shoulders. And then I'm doing just a little bit of work on arms. It's just like 20, 30 minutes each day on arms, biceps and triceps. Some days I've been doing just biceps, some days just triceps. And what I'm trying to do is to just get them in the best condition that I can because they are a weak point for me. I'm also going to be hitting shoulders 2 to 3 times per week. I have one day consistently just set for shoulders, and then I'm also throwing in shoulders on my leg day, but specifically the medial or lateral, whatever you want to call it, and the posterior deltoid, because my front delt is going to be getting enough work and it is overdeveloped for me. And again, at this point, I'm not going to make any huge changes to my physique. I'm just trying to do everything I can to enhance what I already have. So I got a hangnail going on. I'll get that out real quick. Anyway, so I am going to be working my front delt on just my shoulder days, but on my leg and shoulder days, I'm only going to be working the medial and the posterior head. My posterior head isn't as firm as I would like it to be, and my medial head could just use some size. So I figure the more I work it, the better. I don't necessarily believe in overtraining. I do believe in giving yourself some recovery time and getting good sleep. But again, when you're doing lighter weights and higher reps, you recover pretty quickly. So two days of shoulders. I'm doing cardio 5 days a week. And since I'd already been doing cardio pretty much 4 to 5 days a week for the last couple of weeks, normally when I start doing cardio, I start small at like 15 minutes 3 to 4 times a week, and then I bump up the number of days, and then I start bumping up the amount of time that I do it. Since I've already been doing it fairly consistently, I'm just jumping in at 20 minutes a day, 5 days a week. As we get closer to contest, it's likely going to be more like 6 days a week, and I'll be way up more towards like the 45 minutes to an hour mark, but I'm just going to slowly each week. So I did 20 minutes last week, I'm doing 20 minutes this week. Next week I'm probably going to start doing 25 minutes, we'll see how I feel. One of the things I have to be very careful about is since I'm prone to dislocating things because of my genetic disorder, one thing that's really, you know, wearing on me right now, especially with the cardio, and it's real early on, so it's something I have to be careful about, is my right hip, which is the one I dislocated about a month and a half ago. Is really bugging me. It's been very sore, very painful. I mean, it feels really loose, like it's not holding in the socket very well. So that's just one of the things that I have to be, that I have to keep an eye on. You notice we're starting to get clean in here? We're almost there. We're getting there. Anyway, so that's just one of the things that I have to be careful about, is making sure, because I refuse to push myself so hard that I get injured, because nothing is worth hurting yourself over, in my opinion. So other people may be more dedicated to this than I am, and that's fine. I just feel for myself in this competition that I don't want to push myself to the point of hurting myself. You know, dislocations suck, strains suck, and I get them often enough without pushing myself, so I don't want to overdo it. So, forgot that hangnail. There we go, I think I got it. Nope, not quite. Alright, let's talk about my plan here. So, we're going to go into my workouts here. Let's go to my workout plan. So right now, I don't have them all set up. I have just a generic arms and shoulders workout set up here. And then I've got a couple of things. So I've got back day, which is, if you notice, just barbell deadlifts and rack pulls. And that's going to be my heavy day. So I'm hitting back and chest twice a week. One day each by themselves, and then a superset day for the volume work. And so during my heavy days of just them by themselves, I'm just doing deadlifts and rack pulls. Now the volume is pretty high on that as far as what I'm doing. I'm doing five sets at, probably gonna bump it up to about 350 this week for three reps, and that's after my warm-up sets. And then I'm also doing heavy rack pulls for 5 to 10 sets, depending on how I'm feeling. On my chest days, I'm doing things like bench press, semi-incline dumbbell presses, barbell incline presses, and dips. I'm actually, while this is a workout that I have set up for me, I'm not going to be doing it. Hamstrings and hips, not worrying about that. I changed my legs from just a pure leg workout to shoulders, so what I've got is the back squat and leg extensions for that. And then the other one that I have to get in there still is my just my pure shoulder workout, which is gonna encompass traps and the deltoids, your upper traps, and or my upper traps, not your upper traps. And then I also have to get in the back and chest workout that I haven't put together yet. So I just this weekend committed to it and I got my workout set up. So typically what that would look like for me is if we go to my calendar here, and this is just gonna show a few weeks here, but I've got everything set up. So I'm committing to knowing what days of the week that I'm doing things. So, but if you look at like last week, so I had something come up on Thursday and I was like, I don't wanna work out today, I'm too tired. And I pushed Thursday to Friday, and I'd actually pushed Friday to Saturday, ended up not doing Saturday. So what I'm doing is I'm committing. So this week already, you can see that I've done my chest. I did arms. It says arms and shoulders, but that's just generic for touch-up work, and that's just for tracking purposes. There's actually not even an exercise inside that workout. And then it says I did running. I didn't do running, I did walking. Today I did my legs and shoulders, so I've already tracked that with all my rep sets and weights and everything. I've still got my walking and my arms to do. And then tomorrow is going to be my heavy back day with my deadlifts. Thursday is going to be just shoulders, and then Friday is going to be my chest and back. And again, I'm hitting arms on every day of the week. I'm also going to be hitting abs 2 to 3 times a week right now. That number is going to increase in volume, but I've got to get them used to working again, because most of my core work comes from my heavier lifts. You know, you're always engaging your core during any heavy exercise that you do, well, any exercise period, but so it's one of those things where I've got to look at this fresh shirt, look at that. Anyway, so it's just one of those things that I've got to get back into doing. So the first 2 weeks of competition prep are just me getting consistent with my workouts. I'm not overloading, I'm not doing crazy, just getting consistent with working out Monday through Friday. I am going to be taking at this point Saturday and Sunday off to recover. And I'm not going to even be doing cardio on those days. Again, as we get closer to competition, I will likely be doing cardio 6 days a week. But I'm probably still going to only work out 5 days a week. So that's the plan as of right now. I actually have the next, I think, month planned out. More than that. Whoops, wrong one. I'm just opening. Sorry, guys. I'm opening up my open other notebooks here. Loading my notebooks. Contest prep. So I'm opening. So I actually started a tracking. OneNote's one of my favorite things. I keep track of everything with OneNote. Personal life, work life, everything. So actually, if we look at it for my goals here, I have everything typed out. You know, this is for yesterday. Today was officially my first day of prep. I was on point with food, although I was low on carbs. And I know that, and I'm still low on carbs today. I think I need to actually bump it up to where I'm actually above my protein. Which I came in way under my protein. I think I was at 220 grams of protein yesterday and only 180 grams of carbs. So I actually want to bump that way up so that when I start carb cycling, it has some effect. So I actually want to get my carbs up a little bit higher. And right now the dieting is not hard at all on my body. In fact, it feels like I'm eating too much, but again, I've got to get that consistency down before I can start dropping calories. So weeks 3 and 4 is when I'm gonna start actually dropping the calories, and I'm only dropping each week by about 100 to 150 calories per week, which will be a great adjustment. Again, I gave myself plenty of time to do this. Now, it may drop by a little bit more by the time we get to contest prep, but one of the things that I'm going into this saying is I'm not gonna plan out the entire contest prep yet. I have a vision and I have some general ideas of what the end is going to look like. But what I wanna do is I wanna see how my body responds. So am I losing weight too fast, too quickly? Am I losing too much muscle? So I'm going to track everything that I do, and we're gonna just kinda see how my body responds to all of this. And that's gonna be incredibly helpful, because in my next contest, should I choose to do one again, I'm going to have all of that information in one easy to find spot. It's just going to be on one, you know, one note. I can go back and look what worked, what didn't, what, you know, I can keep track of everything so I have a better idea. This first one is going to be just me getting an idea of what this looks like for me. So, and I'm perfectly happy with that. I think it'll be a great idea. One of the things that I am going to do is I'm actually thinking about doing my contest prep at a gym other than Whetstone, other than the one that I'm working out of right now. Just for that pure fact of I work there, I end up getting distracted and talking to people. Like even today, during my workout, the manager came up and she just had some business stuff. We had to set up a meeting with the owner to go over contracts and stuff because my contract is up this month. And what ended up happening was I was in the middle of finishing my last few sets and I took too much of a break and I felt like I kind of lost some of my momentum. So it's just one of those things where I don't want to be distracted and I actually don't want to know everybody there. So we have a 24-hour fitness fairly close by to me that I'm thinking about signing up just on a month-to-month basis, not doing a contract with them so that I can really focus on my training. I'm actually doing my cardio here. So if we go look down, and you'll have seen in a previous video, but right down there, which is really nice, right there is the, I don't want to say Welcome Center, I guess it is the Welcome and Rec Center, so they've got, that's where my last video that you would have seen, that's where I've been doing my cardio. So I'm planning on doing my major workouts and my arms, obviously, at the gym, and then I'm going to be doing my cardio here so that I'm a little bit closer to home. And some of my cardio is going to be outdoor cardio because I fucking hate being on a treadmill all the time, excuse my language, but it just drives me fucking insane. I hate it. So that's kind of the plan. And I guess this is just my initial, or not initial, official announcement of contest prep. And I'm going to be taking you guys with me. My goal is to be releasing 2 videos a week. Something more along the lines of a vlogging video for at least one of them and more of a trainer edition for another. So you guys can see the tips and tricks that I'm using to get ready. And I can explain things. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the explanation of what I was doing in my deadlifts and the tips that I gave. I'm going to be doing more trainer edition videos like that. Less of the music and more of me actually explaining what's going on. And then some of it will just be vlogging, so during my workouts there'll be music and it'll be cool and blah blah blah. But okay, so kind of went over everything there, what my training plan looks like. I need to actually get my measurements going. Sorry, my brain is not freaking working today. So again, I can track this all through my app, which is really nice. I do have, if you guys are interested, I do have, mine's all tore to hell, but I do have contest prep books or just regular workout journals. They work either way, that has everything written down. And I like the idea of this, but to be perfectly honest with you, I am a total nerd. And so, like, to be honest, for those of you that didn't know, you know, my thing sitting on my screen right now, it's World of Warcraft. I've got my Steam account up. If you guys ever want to play with me, hit me up. Havoc Silencer on both accounts there. We can play some World of Warcraft. We can play some Overwatch. We can play some Call of Duty. We can play whatever. Anyway, that's how I decompress, is just video games. It's a distraction from my joint pain, and it's just fun for me to do. So, anyway. Computers just make things easier for me. So that's how I'm doing this particular tracking session. So I'm going to set you guys down, and then honestly, part of this is probably going to be fast forwarded, but you guys will actually get to see how I do my measurements. So let's see here, are we in frame? We are. So I'm going to get a little bit more lighting in here, mess up just a little bit, there we go, that's better. So good old measurements, got to have the shirt off, obviously, duh. So as you guys can see, I'm not super lean right now. I don't know if you guys can actually see that. Let's open this up all the way. There we go, that's better. So I'm not super lean right now. I've got some definition, some of my shoulder work is coming in, but I don't have the abs yet. Definitely they're not there, and they need to be. So first thing I'm going to do is a body fat caliper test. So actually I'm going to open up a second website here. Let's see here. Actually, I don't know, since I haven't done it, whether or not. See, I've got this pooch right here. Everything else is looking somewhat good. If I hit a close here, get those lats going. So that's all, it's coming in. I keep saying I did my bolt wrong last year, which I did, but I did get some results from it. I'm starting to see that, so that makes me happy. Body caliper, body fat percentage. Let's see here. How do I add all of this in? I guess maybe I have to... Oh, I see. Okay, caliper chest. Oh, okay. I see. I have to do that portion from the mobile app. So we're going to open up Trainer Eyes here. And this is my handy dandy app. Same thing, same screen, same app. So we'll go in. I'm already in the... So current weigh-in. I haven't weighed myself yet. I was 212 yesterday. But that wasn't accurate because I've eaten and taken in water. So... Let's see here. Body fat, caliper body fat percentage. Let's go into that. Okay, so let's head in real quick and get a real quick chest definition. Just kidding. Let's get a real quick weigh-in. Again, it's not going to be totally accurate because I've eaten and drank today, and I'm going to do it with my socks on because I'm lazy. But fact of the matter is, look how orange it is in here. This lighting is terrible, but if I turn this on, the fan turns on, so... Oh, yeah. So, let's see here. What do we got? What do we got? We are going to be at 210.2. So, 210.2. Cue the fast forward. I'm just kidding. I just walked really fast. Okay, so, let's set this down. Again, set you guys down. Again, those abs, not there yet. They will be, though. They will be soon. Okay, so weight was 210.2, whatever. Body fat percent. So we're going to use, this is really nice because it gives me the caliper method. These are my calipers. And these are the shittiest calipers I've ever owned. And they're so inaccurate. But I'm going to use them anyway just because that's what I've got. I'm going to use the right side of my body. I don't know why they always say the right side, but they do. So we're going to do chest. And really what these do is when you click them in, you're looking for this piece right here to click, and then you've put enough pressure. We want to go, as far as the point goes, we want to go from the nipple to the shoulder, that halfway point right about here. I'm going to pinch in, and I'm actually going to do it right-handed. So that's showing about 10 millimeters. That's closer to 8. I'm going to do it 2 to 3 times just to make sure. And you want to make sure you're grabbing just the skin. Yep, got 8 that time. One more shot here. Yep, getting 8. So 8 is what I'm getting for the chest, and these are all in millimeters. Okay. Abdomen, right side. You want to go from, again, these are really shitty calipers, but we want to go from the hip bone up to the belly button, just to the right of it. So right about here. So right here is where I'm going to measure. I'm going to try and pinch. Ab measurements are always harder. I'm coming in, I'm getting about a 12 there. I like to rub the area, just kind of reset the skin. You can see I'm a little flabby. Just kidding. But I'm not. So, getting a 12 again right there. Rub it off, wait a few seconds, and then we're going to do it again. I'm just getting the skin. Got a 12 there again. So abdomen is going to be 12. Thigh. So we want to go from the top of the hip
which is right here. So you want to find that point right there to the knee. And we want to do that halfway point. So for me, that's going to be roughly right about here. You can ignore my nice little heart tattoo there. I'm so glad I'm doing men's physique and I don't have to show my legs, because my legs are very, very tattooed. I don't know if you guys knew that or not, but anyway. From the hip, top of the hip here, so it's going to be, for me it's nice because I can always measure pretty much right from my heart. I'm going to put my legs straight, and I'm actually going to, you can't see this, but I'm flexing my toes up, okay? Which makes it easier to grab the skin at that point instead of just the muscle. Grab that. I'm getting about an 18 for that reading. Rub it off here. Come back in. Stand up a little bit straighter. Flex. I've got about an 18 there again. And again, these are super inaccurate. Getting about an 18 again. So my average was 18. It wasn't perfectly on 18, but same thing. So, body caliper wise, it's showing me at about 11.07%. Which is, I would say, plus or minus about 1%, but it is showing a 1% drop from the last time I did this about 6 weeks ago. So, got cardio and kind of getting my diet in order. As you guys see that I have a open thing. I haven't given those up yet. I haven't given up my energy drinks. That's part of what the next 2 weeks are going to be about, is tapering off of those as well. So, body fat percent, 11.7. So, we got to do measurements. Which I wish I had someone here to help me with this, but I'm just gonna do it myself. I've got this crappy tape measure that's supposed to be really good for this. So let's measure the arms. And again, I'm measuring all of this without, you know, the pump, right? You know, after working out. I am gonna measure my arms flexing just so I don't feel terrible about myself. About 15 and a quarter on the left. I would expect this one to be a little bit thicker, as I am right-handed. Nope, about the same, good. That means, so one of the things I'm looking for here is inequalities. So if my right side is bigger than my left, then I know that I need to, for that specific body part, I need to be doing a lot of unilateral work. So, 15.25. This particular one has me measuring forearms, and that's fine. No big deal. So we're going to go to the medius portion of the forearm. And you want to, when we talk about proportions, and this isn't necessarily true for men's physique, but when we talk about like the ideal physique, and this is something that one of the guys that I like to follow, Rich Piana, is always talking about, is shoulders to that skinny waist, and then V tapering out. So, and I kind of tend to agree with his idea of a perfect physique, is that your shoulder measurement should be double your waist, and your single leg should be the same as your waist, and then both your legs put together should be double your waist, so you're literally going in a perfect X. So real wide tapering down, and then real big legs. Now for me, that's not gonna happen, and they don't worry about that so much in men's physique. My legs are not developed enough yet, but any who's it's. So my left forearm, back to what I was saying about forearms. Forearms, you want roughly the same size as your, is it neck? Yeah, arms, the same size as calves. Forearms is the same measurement as your neck. So my forearm, my left is 12. My right is hopefully 12. Yep, perfect. So 12 and 12. So let's get the, this one's going to be the hard one for me. Neck. Open this up quite a bit here. I'm just going to close it around my neck right there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold the tape here and I'm going to open up, oops, not right there. I'm going to hold the tape right here at this marker, and I'm going to pull this tape out, because if I don't, it'll hold in place. So I'm about 15 and a quarter on my neck. So my forearms are actually 3.5 inches, 3.25 inches smaller than my neck. So my neck, you know, those proportions aren't quite right in my head. Chest. Chest is going to be a bigger one for me. So when you're measuring chest, you got to remember that you're also measuring your back, not just your chest. So I go just above the nipple line. For women, I actually go in the upper chest because there's really no point of measuring the breast size. That kind of makes it stupid, in my opinion. So I've never measured women that way. Probably never will, because I feel from a check-in standpoint, it's better to measure the upper chest for women. Now, whether or not that's the correct way to do it, or anyone else feels that way, I have no idea. So, right around there, making sure I've got this up high enough across my shoulder blades to get all of that measurement in there, because again, your chest is a measurement of your back, your serratus, and your actual pectoral muscles. So I'm at 42 inches on my chest here. We're gonna do our shoulders last. I'm gonna do waist. Waist now, waist is right at the belly button. That is the waist measurement. So, as you can see, I'm holding body fat in this area, so right now my waist is measuring at 34. I graduated high school at a 32 inch waist, but I'm thinking when I get down to contest size, I'm gonna be somewhere between 29 and 30 inches. That's the goal anyway. So I'm at 34 inches right now on the waist. Hips. I used to do hip measurements wrong all the time. You actually want to go around your glutes and then find the top of that hip bone, around the glutes, top of the hip bone. I'm not going to do this naked. You guys don't need to see that. Out there. The meatier part of my hips there, my glutes. And I'm at roughly 42 and a half inches. From a health standpoint, that's really good because my hip measurement, your waist measurement should always be smaller than your hip measurement. It's when your waist measurement is bigger than your hip that you're at higher risk for like heart disease and all that good stuff. So now we're gonna take this off and we're gonna do our thighs. Thigh measurements, some people do them differently than I do them. I go for the meatier part of it just because that's the thickness of it. I think the technical, if I'm not mistaken, the technical correct way to do it is standing up nice and straight and then measuring from your fingertip down. But for me, that's not the meatiest part of my thigh. So we're gonna come in here and I've got roughly 24 and a half on my left. And I'm actually gonna measure my calf on here just because it's easier to do that way. Now, these are gonna be weekly. Normally I suggest to my clients doing these monthly. If you were working on like a weight loss or a bulk. But since I'm literally being super specific about everything that I'm doing, and I'm trying to have that micro control, I'm going to be doing this on a weekly basis. And since I'm doing it on a Tuesday, I guess Tuesdays are going to be my check-in day, which works out just fine for me, I guess. So, 16, about 16 and a quarter on both calves. And again, if I'm looking at my calf to forearm, my calves are only about an inch bigger than, calf to arm ratio. My arms are a little bit smaller than my calves. One of the reasons I'm working on my arms so hard right now, you know, 5 days a week. So, and again, guys, when I say I'm working on forearms 5 days a week, it's really not, or forearms, dear God. When I'm working on arms 5 days a week, I'm only hitting them for about 20, 30 minutes. Not super heavy on anything. I'm getting my heavy work in on my chest and back days, so really just focusing on that. My right thigh is actually only about 24 inches, so it's a little unequal. That doesn't surprise me in the least bit because this is the side where I have a torn meniscus and MCL, so I've probably been favoring my left a little bit more lately. So the last one is the shoulder measurement, which is super freaking hard to do by yourself. Just saying. So let me get in here. This down. This across here. And then I gotta get this arm magically in here. It does make it easier having this particular tape to do this measurement with. That is not quite right because I'm not at the widest portion of my shoulder. So, we're going to call that 49 and a half. So, if my waist is 34 inches right now, which it is, but my shoulder measurement should be hopefully double that. And so it's definitely not. It's only about 16, 17 inches, I guess.
Bigger. So, measurements done, check-ins done. Again, I'm gonna be doing this, I guess, every Tuesday since I did it on a Tuesday. So that's all that. We'll do the check-in. If you guys wanna see, I guess I could show you here real quick. This is great. If you guys ever do coaching with me, this is one of the tools that you'll get to use. We'll save that as a measurement. And the nice thing is I can track all of this. So if I go to my progress here, if I go up here to progress, and again, this is all done from an app. Since this is my first check-in, it's not really gonna show a whole lot, but it does show that I went up in weight, and it's just gonna show all of my, it'll show my fat mass and all that stuff. So it does have a lot of good, tools that I'm gonna use to track everything every step of the way. So that's enough for today. This is just a vlog to let you guys know that yes, I did decide to compete. Definitely, like I said earlier, I'm shooting for 2 videos a week. One gonna be a vlog, one's gonna be more of a trainer edition. So keep an eye out for that. Hit subscribe, make sure you hit thumbs up. If you did like it, if you didn't like it, F you, hit thumbs up anyway. And I will see you guys later.
Out.